Milwaukee Bucks, the Admirals, and the Marquette basketball teams all teaming up now in opposing the opening of a strip club just across from their home arena.
And new at 6:12, news reporter Nick Vore is live at the Bradley Center with the growing opposition.
And Kathy, this former bar and restaurant space here would become a strip club if the owners of Silk Exotic get their way. But it's the proximity to the BMO Harris Bradley Center right across the street here that has the three sports teams that play here speaking in one voice.
The proposed strip club next to the BMO Harris Bradley Center has the three teams that play there playing defense.
To walk outside and have a gentleman's club right across the street that they're going to have to walk by is going to be, not the greatest first impression.
A letter from Admirals President John Greenberg and the leaders of the Bucks and Marquette Athletics calls on the Milwaukee Common Council to reject Silk Exotic's plans for the vacant restaurant and bar space at 4th and Highland. Quote, without a doubt, the presence of a strip club will change the way our neighborhood is perceived and hurt our business, the letter reads, saying fans, quote, would be involuntarily subjected to having to deal with a strip club's existence when they visit our home. Silk's lawyer says those concerns are unfounded.
Won't have windows you can look in and watch the strippers. That won't have even a sign outside that identifies it as a place where one can see exotic dancing.
Still, the teams don't want Silk directly targeting their fans.
It sounds great if you're the business owner that all those people are going to be coming here, but when your guests are primarily families like ours are, this isn't something that fits for us.
Now, the sports teams aren't the only ones that speak out against this. The BMO Harris Bradley Center itself has also registered opposed to the latest efforts for Silk Exotic to locate here in downtown Milwaukee. Those plans, again, are still moving forward at this time, but the Common Council would have to approve it once again. Reporting live here at 4th and Highland, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.